Good evening. Welcome to Viewpoint. I'm Zakir Jacob. The central government has finally agreed to supply 700 metric tons of oxygen to the national capital, Delhi, something that they were not particularly keen on doing because other cities were managing with far less oxygen supply per day. But finally, the center has had to agree because the Supreme Court insisted. The bigger question, though, now is, now that the requisite oxygen is available, will the Delhi government ensure that every needy patient in the capital gets oxygen, and that people will not have to run from pillar to post in search of oxygen, and that not a single person in Delhi will have to die for want of oxygen?
जब तक ये कोरोना की सेकंड वेव कम नहीं हो जाती, हमें डेली 700 टन ऑक्सीजन की ज़रूरत है।
So this daily back and forth between the center and the Delhi government, hopefully we'll not hear any more of it. But this is what has been happening over the last few days, as the central government insisted one thing and the Delhi government insisted something else. This politics of oxygen. The center's charge is that as of yesterday, 730 metric tons of oxygen was given. It is way more than what Delhi requires. The Delhi government's claim is that they need at least 900, but at the very minimum, 700 metric tons of oxygen is required by Delhi for various Delhi hospitals every single day. The center says that, compare this to Mumbai or Bangalore or Chennai or other cities, Delhi is getting much, much more than other cities with a similar caseload, whereas the Delhi government says that lives are getting lost because of delay over oxygen supply. The center has said that excess oxygen for Delhi also would mean other states, particularly North Indian states, will have less oxygen to deal with. The Delhi government says that many states are getting more oxygen than what they are demanding. The center has also said that the oxygen supplied by the center will not be distributed by the Delhi government. The Delhi government's claim is that it's open to a proper audit on the supply. In fact, the center's charge initially was that the oxygen that's being supplied by the center is not being properly distributed by the Delhi government. The Delhi government has said that they're open to an audit. Arvind Kejriwal spoke right after this decision was taken at the nudging of the Supreme Court, and this is what he had to say.
दिल्ली को 700 टन ऑक्सीजन की ज़रूरत है। कल पहली बार केंद्र सरकार ने 730 टन ऑक्सीजन भेजी है। हम तहे दिल से दिल्ली की जनता की तरफ से उनका मुख्यमंत्री होने के नाते मैं केंद्र सरकार का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। मैं दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। मैं दिल्ली सुप्रीम कोर्ट का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। लेकिन एक दिन 700 टन ऑक्सीजन आने से काम नहीं चलेगा। जब तक ये कोरोना की सेकंड वेव कम नहीं हो जाती, हमें डेली 700 टन ऑक्सीजन की ज़रूरत है। ऐसा ना हो कि कल 700 टन आई और आज फिर से 400-300 टन आ जाए, फिर से सारे अस्पतालों के अंदर हाहाकार मच जाएगा।
All right, joining us on the talking point now, Anila Singh is spokesperson of the BJP. Dr. Arun Gupta is president of the Delhi Medical Council. Preeti Sharma Menon, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party. And Dilip Sherin, founder and consulting partner with Perfect Relations. I'll start with you, Anila Singh. For the longest time, through the course of the hearings in both the Delhi High Court and in the Supreme Court, the central government's stand was Delhi does not require 700 metric tons. Finally, you've come around, you've had to come around, because the Supreme Court insisted, please make 700 metric tons available. So will you at least concede that you are being stubborn, obstinate, and not willing to give in to what Delhi was demanding or asking for?
First of all, central government is not at all stubborn. Rather, I'll say that central government is in coordination with all the state governments and extending its help in every way and on all the parameters. If I talk about Mr. Kejriwal, I mean, so I can say, इन सच अ ड्रामेटाइज वे ही इज सेइंग मैं केंद्र की सरकार का धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ, मैं प्रधानमंत्री जी का धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ, मैं सुप्रीम कोर्ट का धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ. आई नीड टू आस्क दिस जेंटलमैन दैट यू आर द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ दिल्ली स्टेट. सर, इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ योर गवर्नमेंट टू टेल दैट हाउ मच ऑक्सीजन यू रिक्वायर हॉस्पिटल वाइज. And we know it very well that lately they have started doing such type of auditing, that how much oxygen is required by the respective hospital so that the supply can be maintained. And this government did not manage to get the tankers, cryogenic tankers. Oxygen was there, but they do not have tankers. They did not book them in time. We know it very well.
All those issues I concede, you're right about that. But will you at least agree that finally you've had to agree to the 700 metric tons only because the Supreme Court insisted?
See, again, I'm going to say one thing here, that it is not about Supreme Court or Delhi government or any other institute. Here, the central government is to help state governments, but state governments, they have to come ahead with the requirement, and that requirement has to be supported by the supply chain management and everything.
Okay.
The thing is, you are saying, mujhko itna chahiye. ठीक है, आपको दिया जा रहा है, पर आप वो चीज पहुंचा पा रहे हो? Do you have that type of management? No.
Okay.
Whether we talk about the hospitals, whether we talk about the supply chain management, we talk
okay, that, about that, that's the a fair bed. Point. So let me ask Preeti Sharma Menon. For the longest time, you were saying the throwing the ball at the center's court and saying we need 700, we need 700, we need 700. Now you've got 700. Now will you ensure that no one has to die in Delhi for want of oxygen? Now will you ensure that hospitals don't have to send SOSs via Twitter and through television channels asking for oxygen? Can you give that assurance, ma'am?
I think what you have to understand is that every state gives its requirement to the center based on a formula given by the central government. Nobody asked for oxygen of so many metric tons pulled out of thin air. Delhi has 6,300 oxygenated beds. It has approximately 4,500 oxygenated ICUs. Based on the formula given by the central government, we have requested a demand on the existing beds as well as the new facilities being put into the Radhaswamy and DRDO facilities. And therefore, we say 976 metric tons, but we are grateful for the 700 metric tons. You please understand, after 15 days of begging and after so many lives being lost, only on the orders of the Supreme Court and the Delhi High Court did we for the first time get 700 metric tons today. So we pray that this is not an aberration. We pray that this will be a consistent flow of oxygen into Delhi. I would like to tell the BJP spokesperson to please note what the Delhi High Court has said. It has categorically said Delhi is not an industrial state. It does not have factories which produce gases and therefore does not own any cryogenic tankers. And therefore the central government must help in delivering the oxygen to Delhi. The Supreme Court was categorical that will 700 metric tons reach Delhi or no. So that was the responsibility of the central government.
No. So now that they're giving you 700, ma'am. Now that they're giving you 700, and they have told the court. Forget about what they've told you and what they've told the public. They've told the court. They have told the court that they will give 700 up until Monday, when the court will convene back again. Now that you're getting 700, can you please assure the citizens of Delhi that they will not have to die for lack of oxygen? Please make that assurance.
100%. The Chief Minister has stated today that now that we are getting 700 metric tons, nobody will suffer because of the want of oxygen. And as far as the distribution of oxygen within the city of Delhi, within the state of Delhi is concerned, there are nodal officers for every hospital, which is more than 100 bed. And those nodal officers are connected to a war room, which is monitored by some of the finest bureaucrats, as well as our top MLAs, as well as the entire administration of the Delhi government.
So you're essentially saying that the entire problem was a supply side problem. You are not getting enough supplies, and that's why the crisis. Let me ask Dr. Gupta as well as Dilip Sharma. Let me go to Dr. Gupta and to Mumbai. Mr. Cherian. One second, ma'am. I've moved on from you. I'm going to other guests, please. Dr. Gupta, what is the situation on the ground? Please tell us, in your hospital, forget about everywhere else, in your hospital, are you seeing things getting better over the last 3 or 4 days now that there is the supply side issue taken care of?
I think the problem started almost 10 to 15 days back, and all my doctors, all the hospitals and nursing homes which are in touch with me. They were really, really concerned. It was not about only about the lack of oxygen supply. It was more about irregularity or inconsistency of supply also. Now, they were not sure ki how much it lasts, whether the cylinder will oxygen will reach in 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. Now, that is such a panic situation for all my doctors. Now, we have 1,100 patients lying in the ICU with oxygen, and suddenly you don't know whether next 2 hour you will get oxygen or not.
Let me get this clear. You are saying it's also a problem of management of oxygen. It's not just a lack of supply issue, but also what we were getting, we're not able to manage properly. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying that if you are getting oxygen for, suppose you are getting oxygen for only 6 hours, only 8 hours.
Yes.
But at the end of 8 hours, you are in a lurch again, whether you will get oxygen for next year or not.
Okay.
So there was not a consistent supply. And as the previous spokesman had already said, the Delhi has oxygen is not something you will kind of release in the air and indulge in luxury also. It is something which is really required. And all my doctors are really worried because most of the patients who are admitted, they need oxygen.
Okay.
Now, oxygen, if you need 700 mt or you need 900 mt or otherwise you need 800 mt, it has to be supplied. It has to be supplied. It's supplied consistently and regularly.
Okay.
So that our doctors are not under tremendous pressure the whole night. They are chasing oxygen cylinders and oxygen tankers.
Of course.
And what? But I agree with the point. Last 2 or 3 days, I'm seeing the situation getting better. And I'm hopefully the 700 metric ton or maybe 8 or 9 was what we're really demanding as per our projection for next few days. Because the 700 metric ton may be good for today. But as the number of cases are increasing, they are increasing number of beds in Delhi. So this may not be good enough for tomorrow.
No, the only good sign is that over the last few days, Delhi is showing a declining case curve. Let's hope that stays that way. But Dilip Charian, are you reassured? Now that the Supreme Court has intervened and perhaps at the nudging of the Supreme Court, both center and state have come to the same page, whether they like it or not. Now that they are making 700 metric tons available, do you think we have the logistical capability, Delhi has the logistical capability to ensure that all the hospitals get the requisite amount of oxygen, at least in as much as nobody has to die for lack of oxygen? In the 21st century, it's a crime that somebody should die for lack of oxygen.
Raka, there are three simple issues. It is not an edifying sight to have a chief minister have to approach either the High Court or the Supreme Court to get oxygen. After all, he's not going to blow it up or something. One. Two, the logistics of it has been explained that there are nodal officers. As long as the supply is regular and assured, I think that it's the state government which will make sure that the last mile connectivity is done. Three, the problem is what the doctor just said, that you are making an estimate of 700 metric tons, and then you're saying, we will discuss this again on Monday. The court wants to discuss it again on Monday, unless it is to raise it from 700 to 800 or 900, depending on the caseload. And you talked about a stabilizing or declining caseload. That's only because you have reduced the number of tests. As a citizen, am I less worried? The answer is I'm not. From the image point of view, as somebody who looks at it, there is no reason why the central government should be having a pitched battle in the middle of a corona battle with the state government. I think that the image of it just does not sit well. If it is a government which has a heart and is concerned about every citizen, it should make sure that what the hospitals are demanding, what the ICU beds are requiring, what the ventilators need, must be supplied, and there should always be that extra margin, which is the only thing which can comfort doctors who are stressed beyond belief.
Okay.
Believe me, today I know a lot of hospitals, we look at them, we understand what they're doing, and let me tell you that hospitals and the doctors and the healthcare workers are at their wit's end.
True.
They're not going to eat the oxygen or steal it and take it home.
Yeah.
It is a question of what the number of patients require. So I think that both as a citizen, as well as someone who looks at the image of what's happening, I am shocked that we are arguing about
it. Yeah, let me go back to the political spokespersons. And Anila Singh, again, both the doctor said this and Dilip also said this. I mean, isn't it strange and sad that it came down to this, that a state government, irrespective of which political party is ruling it, had to approach the Delhi High Court and the Supreme Court for something as basic as this?
See, when we talk about this particular virus, we know it very well. We means not only Bharatiya Janata Party, each and every person living on this planet knows it very well that it doesn't recognize any political party or the area or the religion or the caste. Mm. When it attacks, when it when somebody is infected, it is, we know it very well that what is the end. So let me tell you here that somebody complaining that because my ruling party is not Bharatiya Janata Party, that is why center, which is central government, which is Bharatiya Janata Party, they are not cooperating with me. So I have a simple question that, sir, fine, you are saying that central government is not listening to you regarding oxygen. So I have a question that almost 11 hospitals in Delhi are under you. So what about the PSA plants? Did you do anything? No, you didn't. So 7 plants are now being made by the central government. You said that you are managing to get 18 cryogenic tankers from Singapore or one of the countries. You didn't. So now more than 7 tankers are being managed by the central government. So I simply have to say one thing here, that the crisis is not of demand and supply alone. Okay. There is supply chain management to distribution within Delhi to better preparation to robust information exchange with the citizens. Because, you know, just now our spokesperson, she said that we have got a war room and we have got the top level bureaucrats, they are managing it. So yeah. When it started in April end. So what the Delhi government was doing, I do not want to get into Tutu Meme, because everybody is Indian citizen.
Yeah, no, so Preeti Sharma Menon, respond to what Anila Singh is asking. I mean, I think 2 weeks back, the chief minister came on TV and said, we're getting cryogenic tankers from Thailand and we're getting cryogenic tankers from France and so on and so forth. Where are these tankers? And why is it that even today, okay, now you're getting adequate supply. Let's assume that the supply side issue is taken care of. There is rampant black marketing of oxygen cylinders. Will you at least take care of that? Or do you need the central government for that also?
So we need the Delhi police, which unfortunately or fortunately comes under the central government. So yes, please, the Delhi police must take strict action against all black marketeers of oxygen, of medicines, and they should not be sleeping on their jobs. This is a crisis when the entire Delhi police, and if the Delhi police is ineffective,
no, ma'am. So is there anything that you
yes,
folks
please.
Will do, or will no, everything so have to can, be done by central government?
Yes, you need to let me speak, because every time I speak, you interrupt me as everybody else.
Because it's also the frustration of an average Delhiite. Average Delhiite who voted for the Aam Aadmi Party and gave such an overwhelming mandate. When push comes to shove, all that the Aam Aadmi is getting is, oh, please ask the centre. Oxygen cylinder, ask the centre. Oxygen concentrator, ask the centre. Supply side, ask the centre.
Can I speak?
No, yes, please.
If you're done with it.
No, yes, please. Yes, I'm listening to you. I'm waiting for an answer.
You're so kind. So kind. Okay. Firstly, we did not ask the citizens to ask the center. The Delhi chief minister with folded hands begged the prime minister on national television that we need 700 metric tons. We've been openly begging for the citizens of Delhi from the central government, because you have to understand allocation of oxygen is a central government responsibility. The central government has stated in court, the attorney general has stated in court, that currently they're supplying 8,500 metric tons to the country. They can raise it to 22,000 metric tons in a matter of hours. So they should be doing that. That's their job. That's not our job. For any state, whether it is us, whether it is Maharashtra, it is their job to supply the oxygen. About cryogenic tankers, I will again call your attention to what the Delhi High Court has said is, and what is the reality is, that Delhi did not own any such things. Delhi had to import them. The process of importing has begun. The center gave us 5 cryogenic tankers, and we have requested for more. And let me explain why.
No, ma'am, what happened to the ones from France?
Again, you're interrupting.
No, ma'am. The chief minister said, I didn't say this. The chief minister came on TV and said, from France, we are getting cryogenic tankers. 2.5 weeks back.
The orders have been placed. In fact, the PSA plant from France has arrived, and that is being installed as we speak. The 8 PSA plants which the central government was to have installed, which they gave the tender out in October themselves, which they took land from us in January, and after which their contractor ran away after making one PSA plant, are also under construction. Plus the Delhi government is making the balance 36, so we'll have 44 PSA plants. Cryogenic tankers have been ordered. But when you're on the cryogenic tankers, please let's understand this. There are more than 1,600 cryogenic tankers in India. they are not distributed evenly. 1600 cryogenic tankers can carry a load of approximately 20 to 25,000 metric tons.
Who owns these tankers? You make it sound like all these tankers are owned by the central government. They're not. These tankers are owned
Neither
by private industry.
Plants.
They are owned by private industry. Anybody
Neither
can hire them.
Plants.
Government
Neither
of Rajasthan can hire them. Government of Haryana
Neither.
Can hire
Neither.
Them.
Neither.
Government
Neither.
Of Odisha
Neither.
Can hire them. I don't know why the government
the
of Delhi cannot hire them.
And the cryogenic tankers are both owned by private parties, but they like the oxygen.
So, ma'am,
if you
put out a contract, pay them money, you can also hire them. Nobody is stopping you.
Everybody is stopping us. We have written to all the states requesting them to give us any excess load that they have of cryogenic tankers. Nobody is providing them. Everybody is holding cryogenic tankers, and therefore we have
okay.
appealed to the central government.
I'll give the final word to Dr. Gupta and to Dilip Charian. I don't know. I only see. Dr. Gupta and Dilip Charian, please. Dr. Gupta, I only see friends, relatives, acquaintances on Twitter as well. Anecdotal evidence that we are getting is that people are still scrambling for oxygen. There are long queues in the black market for oxygen cylinders. I'm really, really hoping that this was just a supply side issue as is being made out by both the political spokespersons. Hopefully, in a day or two, this will get addressed. But I don't know. The reality sometimes belies hope. Are you hopeful, sir, that at least in the hospital situation will get better? Leave alone, people who are getting treated at home.
Well, as far as this political and bureaucratic establishment is concerned, I'm very disappointed to say. I'm very, very disappointed. I don't have any hope either. This is the country where 1,000 doctors have lost their life in this battle. And we are still fighting. We are still battling it out. But when it comes to basic necessity like oxygen, every hospital in Delhi, whether it's central government as well, state government or private hospital, they all had lack of oxygen for last week or so. It's not about distribution. It was lack everywhere. Almost 50% of beds were lying vacant because of lack of oxygen. And this is the country where we hold rallies, where we go to elections and people are dying and doctors are dying. And what sense you are talking? Actually, as a doctor, as a medical community, we are very unhappy. We are very, very disappointed with the way things are going. And we are losing life on one hand. On the other hand, you're making such rallies and sub religious places and all other things. So it's like life is going normal.
Yeah.
Why should my doctor lose life for these people?
I agree with you. I think that sentiment is absolutely well articulated. I mean, why should doctors be the ones who are losing their lives in a desperate bid to try and save the nation when our politicians can't seem to come on the same page? Dilip, I'll give you the final word. 30 seconds, please. Are you hopeful that the situation will get at least slightly better, at least in the institutionalized arenas, which is in hospitals, leave alone, the tens of thousands who are, battling at home?
I think that the big problem was a supply side issue. Supply side issues also include delivery systems. And I'm hopeful that at least once the 700 tons are available, then hospitals will be able to divide it up evenly. But keep in mind, as I said, that the surge is not yet over, and we need to be prepared for the fact that you will need to plan for more. And as citizens, we deserve the right for a government that can actually deliver both at the central level and at the state level.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much, Dilip Charian, Dr. Gupta, Preeti Sharma Menon, and Anila Singh for joining us. Fingers crossed the situation in Delhi will get better in the next few days. Meanwhile, other news, Prime Minister Modi today held a meeting to review the state and district-wise COVID situation as well as the availability of medicines across states. The Prime Minister has also taken note of India's vaccination drive and exhorted states to ensure the pace of the vaccine rollout does not slow down, because on the ground, it has slowed down quite substantially over the last few days or so. A complete lockdown will come into force from the 8th of May to the 16th of May in Kerala. This is even as the state has reported a record high of more than 42,000 fresh COVID cases under a single day today. Under the new guidelines, only essential services will remain open. Restaurants will be allowed to deliver food till 9 p.m., while only 50 people can attend weddings. Former union minister and RLD chief Ajit Singh has passed away because of COVID-related complications. His son Jayant Chaudhary took to Twitter to confirm the demise of the formidable agrarian leader from Western Uttar Pradesh. Tributes have been pouring in from senior politicians, including Prime Minister Modi. MOS External Affairs V. Muralidharan's convoy was attacked allegedly by TMC cadre earlier today in West Midnapur in Bengal. The BJP leader shared a video of the attack in which you can see unknown miscreants damaging his vehicle's window. They also attacked his personal security staff. Meanwhile, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has accused union ministers and senior BJP leaders of trying to incite violence by the state. The TMC Supremo has announced no mantri will be allowed in the state without a negative RT-PCR report, adding that they will be sent into quarantine.